We are back again, checking out the best gaming setups here on the Reddit Battle Stations. I got a good feeling today is gonna be a good episode, so kick back and relax and let the Reddit Wars begin. So you just finished building a PC and you're greeted with this horrendous message on your screen. Well, fear not, because I have an easy solution for you guys. Head on over to yourcdkey.com and pick up a Windows 11 or Windows 10 Pro CD key for around 15 bucks. Just put in the code TS20 to get that extra 20% off, and afterwards they will email you the CD key, and all you have to do is go into your activation settings on Windows and put it in. Afterwards, the watermark will disappear and you can enjoy all the features from Windows. Kicking off the episode strong with Johnny's decked out battle station. We ain't messing around, guys. Like I said earlier, we got triple monitors, a wall-mounted PC, and a bunch of Nanoleaf panels. Ladies and gents, this is what I'm talking about. I got a feeling all the setups today are gonna be as epic as this one. Okay, to be fair, if I had to pick any of my pets to use as mouse space, I would certainly pick my dog. For some reason, the dog's nose has an insurmountable amount of surface area. So, points for that. Some would call it messy, but I love it. Honestly, I don't see anything messy about it. You organize the out of your collectibles and the games. I would say it's more busy or cluttered, but I wouldn't say it's messy. It's actually very impressive, the level of precision that went into organizing everything on the shelves. But the biggest question is, do you still have your virginity intact? All jokes aside, this is a very cozy and comforting room that you built here, but I wonder if you ever play any of the older games that you have on the shelves, or are they there just for display? I'm always curious if the collectors play any of the stuff they display, or they just simply collect and display. Maybe some of you guys can chime in the comment section below. I'm very, very curious. Man, looking at the Nintendo on the bottom brings back so many memories. This room is so nostalgic to me. I remember my mom worked so hard and saved up for years to buy us a Super Nintendo. And the first game my brother and I played was Donkey Kong Country 3. And that was the exact day our obsession with video games began. But yeah, very cozy and nostalgic setup for sure. So this one's a very clean, ultra-wide setup, but the Alex unit doesn't really make much sense here. He would have to move the keyboard and mouse every time he needs to open the drawers. This is something I've noticed in a lot of setups on Setup Wars. I mean, sure, it looks very nice in the setup and it raises your monitor to a more comfortable height while giving you more storage space, but you kind of sacrifice desk space in the process and the convenience in accessing the drawers. Personally, I would pick up these super cheap steel legs that you can probably find at your local hardware store and install it underneath the Alex unit. It will raise it high enough to where the drawers will clear over your keyboard and you will have extra space underneath it to store whatever you want. Also, I don't know how I feel about the cup of tea being that close to your peripherals. I'd much rather put that on a cup holder that you can clamp on the side of your desk. It's a much safer route. In fact, I did feature one in a previous Cool Tech video on the channel last year. It's got a groove on the side where the handle can easily slide in. It's pretty neat. And lastly, I gotta say it, okay, a mouse pad would be nice to protect your beautiful countertop from getting scratched, and also will provide a nice surface for your mouse to glide on. There are several designs that will fit your color scheme really nicely, theosaurus.tech/store if anyone wants to check them out. Damn, this one's pretty badass actually. Solar was able to use up the entire wall for two battle stations and we still got room for activities. Very, very good use of space. We got the floating desk, the floating monitors, floating shelves, the PC. I love it. I just wish the keyboard and mouse cables were ran underneath the desk to fully commit to the minimal theme, but I mean, this is still one hell of an accomplishment. I can't really tell from this angle, but it looks like the rear fan on both PCs are set to intake instead of exhaust. And it doesn't look like there are any fans in the front for either of them. So I'm curious what the temps are in both of the builds. Some cheap power supply cable extensions from Amazon will go a very long way for both the systems. But yeah, I'm digging the setup. Nicely done. Oh, this one's nice. This one's a beauty. I love the simplicity of this one. I can't tell what I like more, the actual setup or the shelf of nicely displayed custom keys. You would think someone who's into building custom keyboards would have a nice mouse pad, but I guess there's no correlation between the two. Here's another poll for you guys. Who here does not use a mouse pad with their setup? And for those who don't, doesn't the friction of the mouse over the countertop bother you? I'm really curious. That aside, I do love the custom numpad and the color scheme. It resonates very well with me. And plus one on the shelf you built for the PC, by the way. I almost didn't even realize it. See, I love this idea so much, but the execution just falls short. Number one, you could have hidden the icons just for the pictures. It would have really sold the camouflage look you were going for. Number two, you could have taken it a step further and either auto hit the taskbar, or you can get this app called Translucent TB. I think that's what it's called. It's a free app that makes your taskbar basically transparent, which also shows more of your wallpaper in the process. Number three, I swear I had one more thing to say. Oh yeah, the wallpaper, it looks upside down because the shadows are off. But yeah, a little disappointed with the execution, but I really, really love the idea. That aside, the setup itself isn't anything exciting, and it also doesn't have a mouse pad. It's okay, I'm fine. You know, I was gonna make another virginity joke here, but that's getting old really quickly at this point. I, for one, can't ever build a setup in a basement. I much prefer the attic if I had to choose. I just won't feel comfortable with all the exposed pipes, wires, and potential mold growing in the crevices. But I understand that sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. If you don't have the space for it in your home, by all means, guys, build your dream setup in the basement if you have one. It does look like a work from home setup, judging by the ancient fossilized landline phone. I wonder how many people still use a landline phone. So there's definitely a lot going on here. We got a laptop powering a few displays, and then we have a custom build over there on the right side that's probably hooked up to the TV. I'm not really sure what's going on here, but this is a very janky setup if I'm being honest. But hey, as long as it's functional, that's all that matters. 21.6K upvotes. Wow, we're getting pretty high up here on the subreddit. And so are the setups. I'm starting to notice a trend here. The higher up your setup is off the ground, the higher the votes are. I mean, it's a nice view, but that's really all there is to it. It's a very basic setup when you take away the windows. I just wish these types of setups were in a different subreddit, that's all. Here we go, a good all-around gaming setup. It's neat and tidy, excellent color coordination, flawless cable management. This right here is a dream setup for a lot of people, and it's not even trying that hard to be. It looks so effortless. Those custom 3D printed risers used to be so popular back in the day, and was all thanks to David's submission from Setup Wars. I can't remember which episode it was, but it inspired me to do the same for a couple of setup makeover episodes. Leo from season 6 with the custom headboard and the dual monitors, and also
Phil. Later that day.
Phillips setup from season 1. These risers look so much nicer than the IKEA capital legs, and they're a lot easier to paint, so you can match it with the color scheme of your setup. But it's also functional, giving the desk a bit of height. In Josie's case, he was able to store his controller and hook up a USB hub on the right side. And by the way, extra points for painting your USB hub. I see you. Of course, you can't have a badass looking setup without an equally badass PC, right? They kind of go hand to hand, and it's almost imperative that your system complements your setup. And honestly, I couldn't have picked a better pair. Excellent choice. Living in a van doesn't mean you can't have a nice battle station. It actually does. That's a very loose definition of a nice battle station. I'm so bad sometimes. I'm sorry, guys. I like to keep it real here, all right? You're sacrificing a lot to build a setup in a van. It might be awesome for the first few weeks, but it's just not sustainable for the long run. Now, if you had an RV or a much bigger van with more space, then I would say it's doable. But no shower, no bathroom, no comfortable bed. Count me out. I mean, is there even space for two people in there? This ain't no battle station. It's a fab station. My guy's even got the lube on standby. Look, I love camping. I love nature. So I can somewhat relate to how it feels like living in a van. You know, always being close to nature and always being on the move. In fact, a lot of people have this lifestyle, which I think is awesome. But I just can't deal with the slow internet. That's like the biggest deal breaker for me. Look, I can deal with the lonely nights in my small bed. I can deal with dropping deuces outside in the forest. Hell, I can even go on for months without showering and smell like Chewbacca. But dial-up internet speeds is where I draw the line. Okay, there's no freaking way. This is the actual Chris Hadfield. It is the real Chris Hadfield. What? We have a freaking astronaut that's on Reddit? That's insane. Well, he does have a lot of time in space, so I guess this is where he spends most of his time. That is so badass, wow. Look at all those tiny monitors and buttons and switches and knobs. This looks way more complicated than flying a plane or even a fighter jet. That's pretty freaking cool, I'm not gonna lie. But that view though, damn. Those skyscraper setups, they got nothing on this setup. But is this an actual setup, right? It's technically a shuttle cab cockpit. You know what? What is the definition of a setup? Let's look this up real quick.
1 minute later.
The way in which something, especially an organization or equipment, is organized, planned, or arranged. Okay. I guess in that sense, yes, this is a setup. It's equipment that is organized and arranged. So yeah, it's also got flawless cable management. So I gotta give a point for that. I mean, yeah, I'm very impressed overall. I know you didn't build this, Chris, but I'm gonna make an exception because you're a legend. See, now this is how you do a retro battle station. The one from the last video had the aesthetics, but the execution was terrible because there was no legroom. This, on the other hand, has both. It's also only 3 months old and already has 22.4K votes. That's insane. I'm getting Fallout vibes with this setup, actually. I love the custom work that went in here. You got the custom monitor frames, the vintage poster, and the wallpaper to tie the whole thing together. It's brilliant, really. It's almost perfect. This was so close in being the perfect time capsule setup, but the keyboard kind of kicks you out of that era and brings you back to the present. That looks like a modern keyboard to me, doesn't it? Like, I'm dying to know why you didn't go with a retro style keyboard to really sell that retro futuristic theme. There are tons of really cool vintage and retro keyboards that you could have gone with. And I only mention this because you seem very dedicated to the theme of the setup and your attention to detail is unmatched, okay? I mean, the fact that the knobs actually work and control the lighting and you hit a webcam inside of that old camera is a true testament to your creativity. But the keyboard is like that one wrong puzzle piece that was forced into a 1,000-piece jigsaw puzzle. I know I might sound overly dramatic and I'm probably nitpicking at the most pointless thing right now, but you guys already know how I get sometimes. It's in my DNA, okay? I'm Ed from Sex Source, so it shouldn't come off as a surprise to a lot of you. Regardless though, honestly, with all that aside, I still think this is one of the most creative setups I've seen in the 7 years of doing setup content. Excellent, excellent work, Beach Buddy. This one is also another creative and fresh take on a floating setup. I absolutely love the custom pegboard that he built, which also doubles as a nice headboard. My wife is also into pegging. That the setup. That was the dumbest joke ever. Oh my God. Oh, this doesn't even make sense. But one of the cool things about this approach is that the setup now has a modular feature. He's able to move the shelves and the pegs around to compensate for any changes in the setup. If he wants more shelf space on the top to add a few more plants, he can just make a longer shelf. Don't like the height of the speakers? No problem, just raise it a little bit more. It's a very clever design that will always evolve with the setup and any upgrades Sleepy Wolf does to it. And here we have the original setup from PC Battle Stations. I think we saw his other setup in one of the previous episodes, but this one is the primary setup that he's currently using, if I'm not mistaken. He was featured back in episode 194, and I'm pretty sure that he was the one who paved the way in using those 3DR panels that we see so many of. This is actually one of four setups that Ryan made. I might be missing one or two, but there was a cyberpunk theme that he made, a Black Panther theme one that was featured on Setup Wars. This guy is definitely skilled and talented at building pretty sweet setups. So it's not a surprise to see his setup being this high on the subreddit. Well done. Guys, I hope you're enjoying the series so far because there is one more episode left before I officially end it. This episode easily had the best setups I've seen so far and I can't wait to see what the last episode has in store. Thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you very soon in the next one. I took a lot of energy. Damn, that intro. I'm so out of shape. Whew. I just wish the key. My laptop just died. Bro, what is this episode?